This is the male model, this is the female model. Heart lies above these kidneys. From the heart, blood is getting pumped into these big tubes. They will become smaller and smaller as they go towards the penis. The blood vessel or coronary artery, which is about 2 to 3 millimeters, goes to the heart, whereas the penis gets an artery or a blood tube which is of only 1 millimeter. So by the time the blood comes from here down, as the age advances or in diabetics or when fats are more, these tubes get clogged. So sufficient amount of blood may not reach over here in obese people also. So that is the cause of erectile dysfunction. Lot of blood has to be pumped inside. Here if you clearly observe, the center portion is known as urethra. This urethra is a tube which comes and opens into the bladder. This is the bladder. These are the kidneys. From the kidney, the urine comes down and gets accumulated in the bladder. Once it becomes nearly a glass full of urine, patient passes the urine outside. These are the balls or testicles. From these testicles, the sperms are being produced. They travel all the way through a tube known as vas. They come over here and they get matured in seminal vesicles. This is the seminal vesicle. From this seminal vesicle, the ejaculatory duct comes and gets opened into the urethra. This is the prostate. The pink color is known as prostate. So whenever somebody has got a semen, it carries not only the sperms, it carries the secretions of the prostate and these paraurethral glands. This is urethra, so paraurethral gland secretions. So many things are put together is known as semen. In that, some sperms also will be there. Just by the side of urethra, a few minutes back I have talked with you. Here, this is the pink, the blue color is known as corpora cavernosa or a spongious tissue, sponge-like tissue. The character of sponge is to take the water inside. Here it takes the blood inside and keeps it for some time. If this keeping mechanism is inefficient, blood goes soon from here. Then that is known as early ejaculation. If the blood coming mechanism itself is insufficient, they will have the less rigidity or less hardness. Here in this diagram, there is a skin, but this diagram does not have that skin portion. We call it as prepuce. Among Muslims and Jews, it is being cut while they are at the age of few years only. Whereas in Hindus, they keep it. Sometimes the opening of this skin is difficult. We call it as phimosis. We do a small surgery because whatever the secretions come over here, it must be cleaned every day. Otherwise, this magma or the retention of all this unwanted material causes the cancer. So this is the requirement of prepuce to be pushed up and washed. There was a misunderstanding that if prepuce is not there, one may have a lot of sexual activity and premature ejaculation is not there. But later on, the scientific data tells that, especially in the old days, the glands sensitivity is much more important. Once the prepuce is removed, the glands loses its sensitivity, it becomes very numb. So that also causes one of the factors for the erectile dysfunctions. In this corpora cavernosa, the blood gets trapped, gives the strength to 550 grams, then only it can enter into the vagina. we have read in Campbell Urology, page number 1086. Just now we have been shown that the axial rigidity must be not less than 550 grams for the penetration. How do you measure the axial rigidity? This is one of the axial rigidity scales. There you could also see one underlined sentence, Rigiscan cannot make out the difference between 450 grams to 900 grams of rigidity. What does it mean? The Rigiscan is a device which measures the girth, increase in the girth in the penis during night time. So usually during night, nocturnal penile tumescence, we call it in scientific terms NPT. During nights the penis becomes harder, a little bit longer, that is being measured by the Rigiscan. But the rigidity is not sufficient. If Rigiscan report is normal, that does not mean that he can have the intercourse. If the Rigiscan report is not normal, still he may have the intercourse. So Rigiscan does not give the total information for the ability to penetrate. One has to evaluate the axial rigidity before the marriage, if somebody wants to get it checked in a scientific manner, whether he is able to penetrate or not, we'll do it. That is known as axial rigidity evaluation by CIS test. CIS means combined injection and stimulation test. This is being done when patient is mentally prepared. We inject a vasoactive drug into the penis and we create an atmosphere where he can have stimulation. Then we'll measure the rigidity, hardness, how hard it is, how much time does it last. All these questions can be answered with the CIS test. If somebody does not have the sufficient rigidity, what should we do? We can give medical treatment like Viagra, Penegra or Tadalafil, or a surgical treatment. Penis, just now I have told you the corpora cavernosa, where the spongiest tissue is there. In that, this tube is cut according to the size of the penis and introduced inside and stitched. It cannot be seen with the naked eye after the surgery. This is a 25-year-old man's genitalia, which did not grow beyond 2 centimeters. And you can closely observe there are no balls or no testicles. And if you see much more clearly, there are 2 scars. He underwent surgery during his childhood. The surgeons have removed the testicles or balls. You can see the same person, scars, these are the scars which I have been showing. So what is the length of the penis? Length of the penis varies from race to race. In and around Hyderabad, the length of the penis is around 5 centimeters. That is flaccid penis. Flaccid means soft. If you go to Punjab, probably it may be 6 to 7 centimeters. If you go to Africa, it may be around 8 centimeters. The flaccid penis becomes harder and lengthier. Once it gains the length, extra length, usually it is around 2 centimeters. Anybody who does not have the length of 3 centimeters comes under small penis. So, small penis evaluation must be done from the childhood itself. The child is not growing accordingly, height as well as the penile length, to be evaluated periodically and get checked. If necessity arises, he may have to be treated with hormones like testosterone or growth hormone. For normal length is about 5 centimeters flaccid penis in and around Hyderabad people. More than the length, it is the strength which gives the ability to have intercourse. So, as I told you, axial rigidity of the penis must be around 550 grams to enter into the vaginal introitus or female genitalia, and it must stay there around 15 minutes. World average intralatent vaginal period is 16 minutes. That means one will have the erection, penetration, and inside the female genitalia for around 16 minutes. This is the average time period. Here we have to take it into consideration length, not less than 3 centimeters, strength or hardness or rigidity, 550 grams and more. Third is the time factor. How many minutes does it stay inside? These three factors to be treated, to be evaluated. Vibrator, specially designed for the ejaculation. Some people cannot have this enough, especially on demand. Usually, whenever they go for assisted reproduction, the husband is asked to get the semen and he is unable to, then the problem occurs. If the patient does not have the semen on himself, he can take the help of the vibrator. He can keep his penis over this vibrator on a gauze piece, so the vibration makes the penis to deliver the semen outside. This is a model of penis. This is known as glans. This is shaft of the penis. As I told you, in and around Hyderabad, it is around 5 to 6 centimeters. The same scale is being used in penile implant surgeries. This is arcadometer to evaluate the volume of the balls or testicles. If the ball size is very small, usually it does not give the sufficient semen. This is an artificial penis. This is not penile implant. It is a mold, plastic mold kept outside. It is difficult to keep in this position. With the help of belts, we try to keep it. Machine. It does not give any electrical shock. The shock is being produced inside the machine. Over this, if the patient keeps his penis, he will not get any electrical shock, but his sexual ability will increase. This is known as ESWL machine. This is the laparoscopic unit. The laparoscopy is used for the abdominal surgeries. Here it is the TV-like monitor which gets the images. Here it is the light source, above is the video. From here the video camera comes, and video camera is adjusted through this telescope into the abdomen. That is known as laparoscopy. Microsurgery. What do you mean by micro? Micro means small. Here I shall try to explain a little. This small tube is known as urethra. From the balls, it comes like this and goes and opens into the urethra. This portion, this is known as seminal vesicle. In the prostate, through the prostate, it comes like this. This portion is known as vas. In a family planning operation to the males, this vas is cut open here and tied. Unfortunately, if the children death is occurred or for some other cause they wanted to have once again the children, we join this tube together. This is known as vasostomy. This is the uterus. This is the uterus when the child is there, when the fetus is there. When fetus is not there, this is the uterus. This is a similar tube which is contemporary to the male vas. These are the ovaries. Ovaries are similar to testicles in the male. Testicles are outside, whereas ovaries are inside the abdomen. From here, the ovum, this blue color one, gets released and gets come over here. And during intercourse, the sperms are released near the cervix in the vagina. They will travel up. This ovum goes up. Both put together, the child, future child will be formed. It is at the level of 2 cells, 1 cell, all the cells. Here, if the tube is cut untied, this is known as tubectomy or family planning operation for the females. This tube also can be joined together. Then, why microsurgery? Microsurgery means they are the very small structures. The routine instruments are not sufficient to catch hold of those very delicate tissue. We use 6-0 proline, sometimes even 8-0 proline to stitch together. It's a very delicate job. We keep microscopes over our eyes to magnify and do the surgery. Even the assistant keeps the magnifier before his eyes. In TPA companies, you can observe. In our hospital, we are empaneled with so many health insurance companies. Here, we do cashless as well as reimbursement. This is regarding test tube baby center. In a test tube baby, we remove the ovum from the ovaries, bring it out under anesthesia. Anyhow, sperms will be outside. These sperms and ovum put together, they are formed as embryo. We transfer embryo after 48 hours, that is known as ET or embryo transfer, to the uterus. This is known as test tube baby. These 48 hours, the sperm and ovum are kept in an incubator, which is imported from Germany or America. Those incubators are very much similar to the mother's womb and hold it for 48 hours. That's why we call it as embryo transfer. This is the stone removed from the bladder. Here this is known as bladder. Here this person did not go to the hospital for quite a few years, so a small stone grew up to this size. It is almost like a heart shape. The bladder is also like that only. These two ends, the ureter gets opened. Here it is the prostatic urethra gets opened here. This patient is from Karimnagar district, Tippai Pali village, which is nearby Vemulawada. How does these stones are formed? The salt inside the body gets stagnated and a small stone is formed. If the stone size is less than 5 millimeters, they get dropped. The stone will never dissolve in any chemical, but stones are passed through. These are the kidneys. From kidneys, whatever the stone is formed, it passes down like this and comes over. The length of the ureter or the tube in between the kidney and the bladder is around 25 centimeters. The stone will not pass immediately, it will slowly move. Each movement causes a lot of pain. The pain is very much similar to delivery pains. Pain is so severe in nature, sometimes patient even vomits and he cannot do his routine work. If you closely observe, there is a difference in the diagram. The left side is normal, right side there are stones. There are three places where the stone comes and stays for a little longer time. These near the vessels here. So once the stone stays there, urine above dilates the ureter, we call it as hydronephrosis or hydroureter. So the ureter gets dilated. Second stop is while crossing these big blood vessels. The stone comes here and stays for some time. Then the third stop is in between vesico-ureter junction. This is ureter, this is vesica. So in between the junction, in between the ureter and the bladder, this gets stacked. So at three places, the stone may stuck. Once it is less than 5 millimeters, 90% of the stones will pass down. Once it becomes 6 millimeters, just 1 millimeter gain makes it only less than 10% stones will fall down. So size of the stone is a very important thing, and position, whether it is in the kidney or in the ureter, upper ureter, middle ureter or lower ureter. According to that, the surgeries will differ. If the stone is above, we can get it powdered with a laser machine, call it as ESW machine. If the stone is below or lower ureter, we call it as intracorporeal lithotripsy. We make the stone powder so that this stone comes out. If the stone is very much big and within the kidney proper, then we do PCNL, percutaneous nephrolithotomy. We make a hole in the kidney, in the skin. We make a track and remove the stones from outside. So, for smaller stones, without any cutting, without making any hole, throw the organ. The scope will pass like this, enter and remove the stone. This is known as URSL, uretero-renoscopy lithotripsy.